Welcome back to Florida TRD. I'm John.
And I'm Clay.
And we're bringing you the differences between the fog lights when you go with the factory fog light option or the 2-in-1. Now, if you watched our previous video, we talked about the differences in daytime running lights. So now we're going to cover what you get with the fog lights with the 2-in-1. So as you can see, his are the factory stock ones with the regular halogen bulbs in it, and mine are the 2-in-1 LEDs. Something that I do like is that it still maintains the halo when the fogs are on. I've seen this system before on other vehicles, and the halo powers down and then it's just the fog light. I do like that it incorporates that. That's kind of like the Ricer Fast and the Furious side of me that likes that, so that works out really good.
So fast.
So
furious.
Yeah, oh yeah, absolutely. So fast. So I do like that it incorporates the halo. The fog lights have a decent performance. That's one thing that I'm not crazy about is that they work good, but they're not great. But not that those are great either. So it's kind of, you know, it's all relative in terms of performance. What I would probably do is, if I was looking for the ultimate in light, is just put a set of rigid fog lights in there. Rigid Industries, they make a D2 fog light kit, and you can drop those in there, and then you'll be blinding everyone that's going down the road. Or buy a HID kit that matches that bulb size and fitment, and then drop that in there and then blind everyone once again. But I went with this option. I paid the extra $200 some odd for the port install option, so I'm gonna rock out with that for a little bit and see what I think. What do you think about yours, Clay?
I'm not fond of them. I'd like to get something different for sure. It's like he said, he paid about $200 for port install on his. To upgrade him to the same as his now, it cost me about $400 plus the time. I have a few options I'm looking at. I've been looking at the Rigid Industries, but we'll see what I end up choosing. I just want it to be a little more intense, a little more bright, and to match the HID headlight color just a little bit better.
Yeah, because it's also, you know, it's not about how well it produces light or anything like that.
Rain
it's
in
about,
Florida.
It's about looking cool. Yeah, imagine that. It never rains in Florida.
This is 2 days in a row with our videos.
Yeah, so I mean, that's how it's been the past week here, just been nonstop rain, but you know, we can't be miserable and hot. Now we have to be miserable, hot, and rainy all at the same time, so you can't get anything done. But yeah, so if you guys are building a 4Runner or speccing it out and wanted an extra option, or see that on the port installed option list, that's what it is. It's definitely cheaper to do it as a port install than it is after the fact. Plus, you don't have to mess with it. The 4Runner comes with it already installed and you're ready to rock and roll. So we just want to go over that with you guys so you can see the port installed option in action. And give you our thoughts and differences on it. If you have any questions, please post them up in the comments. And if you haven't done so already, please like and subscribe. And we'll see you guys next time.
Adios.